Hello, dissenters. My name is Etalyx, and I am here today with a game called Gas Guzzlers on the PC. This is a racing game, also a racing combat game, and it's been out for a few months, but it's only recently received a demo. And you know what that means? I am here playing the free stuff, the stuff that you can play for free. But, of course, if you do enjoy the game, you can purchase it to get, obviously, all of the features and all of the gameplay additions that you're going to get for $26. That is the price point, and I'm playing it from Desura, and I've got links to this game so you can try out the demo for yourself in the description of this video, or if you want to purchase it, you can do that as well. I believe this game is currently trying to get on Steam Greenlight, so I provided a link for that also. Anyways, guys, let's go ahead and hop into the game. First thing I want to show you is the options, because they're actually quite robust. If I'm looking at the graphic settings here, we've got all kinds of options available to us, from volumetric light scattering to anti-aliasing, fog quality. We can scroll down. You can see that there are quite a number of ways to customize this, because it is a very pretty game, and it could be a little bit taxing on your computer, so you can tone these to your liking to try to get more frames per second out of it. And it does support, I believe, multiple input devices. I want to say it supports a controller, judging by the joystick, but I don't have one, so I can't prove that. But you can rebind keys, which is always great. However, the one thing that kind of stinks is that you cannot bind keys to the mouse. I'm not sure why this limitation is in place. You do have to use the keyboard in order to play. You can't do keyboard-mouse combos. But that being said, let's go ahead and jump into the game. So I'm going to click resume here to go back to my little demo campaign that I'm going on right now. So we got a little bit of shameless advertising, but that's okay. You can see we do have a huge gun on top of our car, two to be exact. And if we go to the car shop, you can actually see how many cars are in the full game. Obviously, these are all locked, with the exception of this one, which is in the demo. However, let's go ahead and scroll all the way to the end, and you can kind of see how fancy the cars are going to get as you unlock them. Quite a few cars here, probably, I don't know, 20 or more. I didn't actually count, but you guys can see a little bit of a preview there, and they do have stats on the left, and they are steadily going up the further we go up the list, obviously. So going back one menu, we can also customize the paints and looks of the rims and the hood and the stickers and all that stuff, so we can choose. There's just so many accessories here and options to unlock, so there's plenty of customization to be had. Change the license plate, the nickname of the car, and so on and so forth. So without further ado, we've got our car, we've got a race. Let's go ahead and jump on in. So now that we're on the actual race select screen, you'll see that there are a few different game modes for us to choose from. Classic race is going to be as close to your standard race as possible. Doing three laps, you're only going to have weapons such as mines, oil slicks, and smoke to deploy behind your vehicle. Every car does have nitrous that you're going to be able to use as well. Battle race, however, I believe is going to be a lot more hands-on, a lot more having to aim, and actually having those machine guns that I mentioned on top of the car being put to use. Knockout, I have not yet played. It says seven laps, which is kind of scary, but I'm assuming that this race revolves around killing other cars and just knocking them straight out of the race, as the name would suggest, but we're going to play the battle race for the purposes of this video. Alright, now that we are actually in the game, you can see the level of visual fidelity that I was talking about. It's actually a really pretty game, and I was very surprised, a little bit taken aback when I first got in, because for an indie title, you don't really expect them to look this good, but how does it play? Well, we are about to find out firsthand. I'm noticing that I appear to be the only sponsored car on this racetrack. The reason I'm not shooting anyone right now is because we don't actually get our weapons unlocked until 45 seconds into the race, and you can see me trying to take advantage of a shortcut there, kind of propelling myself into second, third, fourth place. Okay, whatever, I'll take fourth place, it's fine. But no, once we hit 45 seconds, we'll start being able to shoot the other vehicles, and the reason for that is because they don't want you to go out of the gate just laying into the guy right in front of you. They want to give you some time to kind of space out, make it a little bit more fair, and that wall really hurts. I feel like if your car explodes, which is a thing you don't want, I feel like you're out of the race here, but I can't be entirely certain. I did try this once before. Did you see that awesome spin that was given by my shotguns? The combat in this game is very satisfying. The driving is okay. I don't think that the driving is anything spectacular, and the reason for that is the handling is not, it just doesn't feel right to me. You do have a handbrake, which you can attempt to, Hey, you with the rockets. You with the rockets, sir. Stop that. I'm touching all over the track. Go away with those. I don't like your rocket launcher. But anyways, when I try to power slide, it just doesn't seem to work, really. Oh, he took my health power up that I wanted. And I'll show you what I mean here in just a second, that this guy will just leave me alone for 3 seconds. Here's a power slide. Yeah, that was a power slide. I don't know. Maybe it improves with the future vehicles. Here's the thing. In the demo, I am using a really terrible vehicle with low top speeds, low accelerations, and low handling, I'm sure. So once you get to the upgraded vehicles, power sliding probably becomes a much bigger thing. But at the moment, it's really lackluster, and I think the highlight of this game is, first of all, the visuals. The visual quality, very high for an indie game, as I've already mentioned. But secondly, the combat. Whoa! That was awesome! That was so cool! That's what I'm talking about. What great timing, Mr. Rocket Launcher Man. Thank you for that. I could not have asked for that to be more perfectly timed if I had tried. So what I'm going to do is get that health, sneak through here, and give him a little taste of my own medicine while slamming headfirst into the wall. I just had to shoot that guy with the shotgun. The weapons are very fun, and I don't know if I've mentioned this already, but there are unlockable weapons. I feel like I did say that, but it's something to work towards. So not only can you upgrade your vehicle, paint your vehicle, unlock more vehicles, and unlock new weapons for your vehicles. Well, I don't know what else I was going with that, but yeah, that's all the stuff you can do, and it's pretty awesome that it's all available for you. So let me use my nitrous here, try to get a little bit of speed and catch up to these guys, and then try to get a good power slide. I guess that was about as good as I'm gonna get, all things considered. Picking up some health. No, okay, that's fine. I'm just gonna go in between both the health and the power up. No big deal, dodging the mines. And I want to catch up to somebody else so I can shoot them. Do I have any nitrous? Yes, I do now. So I'm going to use that and try to get my health back here. There we go. Power slide around that corner. Very, very good. I'm so surprised with myself. I should have taken that shortcut, but that's okay. I am... Why is the health right before I slam into the wall? Why can't I pick it up like right afterwards? Let's see if we can knock this guy off track. It does seem to kind of auto-aim for you, but if you want to... You can actually switch camera angles, and I'll show you that after I'm done picking on this guy. Come on. Get rid of your shield. I just blew off his trunk. He's getting away, though. And he got health. Not cool. Shotgun, not so good for mid-range fights, I'm just gonna say. Being right up on that guy is great, but otherwise, not so much. Anyways, let's go ahead and mess with the camera angles here. So pressing C, I can actually go into a first-person perspective, which does give a nice sense of speed. However, it can be a little bit more difficult to drive because you can't really see the road ahead of you very well. You do get a crosshair that's going to help you, obviously, shoot the cars ahead of you. Which reminds me, you can actually shoot behind you. I can look on the mini-map at the top left and try to press the right button to actually shoot the car behind me. Probably not nearly as effective as shooting in front of me since I can't really see where I'm aiming. However, it is possible for you to do. I am in, what, fourth place right now? I'm going to see if I can catch up to go to at least third. I am on medium difficulty. There are three different difficulty modes to choose from. And this guy with the machine gun is really giving me a bad time. I love that turn. There's something just nice about it. Let me see if I can get this shortcut here and catch up to this guy. Hopefully losing the guy behind me in the process. And we're going to use the last... No, okay, he's just going to shoot me with his shotgun from behind. It's cool. Pick up the health and move on. What lap are we on? 404, so the race is almost over. Overall, I want to say that this game is a lot of fun. I love the visuals. The handling is okay. The combat is really fun. There seems to be a good amount of variety in the different types of maps so far. This is completely different from the last one that I was on. And it's just fun. I don't know if it's worth the price point, though. That is my point of contention, I do believe. The overall price point is $26. This is currently me playing the demo of the game, which was just released October 3rd. So, being that price point, I don't know. $26 is pretty steep for an indie racing game. I feel like the racing market just really not that good right now. And since the game did come up, you know, I guess the game was released five months ago maybe? The online community has probably mostly dissolved. I haven't actually gotten to check the online because I don't think that that's available in the demo. However, that is one place that I would be skeptical, because I remember when I went to play the last Ridge Racer, the online community was still small and the game had just come out like a day before. So, you know, a 5-month-old indie racing game, I don't think the online community is going to be that strong, but if you want to play for the single player, you just want to have fun with the combat and just upgrading your vehicles, probably a good investment, but then again, I don't know, $26. It's hard for me to justify that because I am frugal and a cheapskate. But I will say that the game's fun, the combat's fun, and if it's something that you want to try out for yourself, you can play the demo and see if it's something that you would want to buy. But I just wanted to spotlight this game to show those of you who might be interested in buying it, because obviously not every game is for every person. I just like to put the spotlight on some of these indie games that may not have gotten much attention, so that hopefully if you guys are interested in it, you can pursue it. Hope you guys enjoyed watching this video, and I hope to bring you some more indie game spotlights here in the near future. If you enjoy this video, please let me know by leaving me a rating, as a like, and a comment below. I would appreciate it very much. Thank you guys for watching. My name is Etalyx, and I will see you next time.